So we're going to take a look here at radicals. And with radicals, we just basically mean like roots. Okay? So hopefully you remember that the, say, square root of 25 is 5. Right? Square root of 25 is 5. Not too bad. And that just means that 5 times 5 is 25, or 5 squared is 25. Now, leaving this kind of open in the front, there's kind of a pretend plus sign in front, so it's positive. It's great. Sometimes people say, well, isn't the square root of 25 plus or minus 5? Yeah, but then we would have written plus or minus square root of, never mind. Don't worry about it, and if you don't know what I'm talking about, don't listen. You want to solve the problem as it's written. So if you have a minus 25 there, that literally means what's the minus of the square root of 25. So minus square root of 25 would be minus 5, like that. So if you see a minus sign in the front, that means give the minus answer. If you see kind of nothing or plus sign in the front, that means give the plus answer. Okay? So remember, let's see, that you can use the same kind of exponent laws that you've used before. So like if I have, you know, I don't know, say 25 over 16, I can apply the square root to the top, and then I can apply the square root to the bottom. So the square root of 25 would be 5. The square root of 16 would be 4. Okay. So let me give you some of these to practice with. Hold on here. Okay, so here are some problems. Work on those for a second. Pause the video, see if you can get the answer, and then come back and see if you got them right. Okay, now assuming you've done that, square root of 36 is 6. These should be, most of them should be pretty fast-ish, kind of. Square root of 0 is 0. Remember, 0 times 0 is 0, so the square root of 0 would be 0. This one we can break up into the root of 4 over the root of 49. So 2/7. Now, if you want to look at this one in particular, this is 0.25. You actually don't need a calculator to do this, in theory, because you could say, well, 0.25 is 25 over 100, right? 25 hundredths. That's literally what that means. 0.25 is 25 hundredths. So that was kind of tricky. Okay, you still need to know how to do it, because it's good for you. Choop, choop. And so that would turn out to be 1/2. Now, if you wanted, you could like have simplified this earlier. You could have said that if you could recognize that that was 25 over 100 was 1/4, you could have done it like that too. I just didn't think about it. But if you did, good job. And if not, don't worry, you got the same answer anyway. Now this one's a little bit tougher. You have to say what times itself is going to give me x to the 6th. If you think about it long enough, hopefully you'll get this times this. Remember, I add the exponents. So that means that x cubed squared, x cubed times x cubed is x to the 6th. So the square root of x cubed, square root of x to the 6th is x cubed. Really the easiest way to do it is to look at this and take half of it. So don't overthink it. Just take, and we'll talk about that more formally in a little while. But, come here. Yeah, I'm just being weird. But yeah, you can just take that 6 and take half of it. Same thing going on over here. Remember, we can separate this out into the square root of 9 times the square root of x to the 12th. Square root of 9 is 3, x to the 12th, square root of that, and we're just going to take half of that, half of that, get x to the 6th. Now negative square root of 81 is going to be negative 9, but the square root of negative 81 is not a real number. I can't actually find that right now. Right, because I can't say, well, could it be negative 9? No, because negative 9 times negative 9 is positive 81. 9 times 9 is also positive 81. I can't multiply two numbers together, two real numbers together, and get a negative value. So We're just going to, for the moment, say that that's not a real number. Now, in addition to square roots, we can also find cube roots. And hopefully you're somewhat familiar with these, but it's like square roots, but with cubes. Wow, that was really descriptive. So like with a square root, we would say, okay, well, 3 times 3 was, let me go. Yeah, let me go 3 times 3 was 9. So that meant that 3 squared was 9. So alternatively, I could take the square root of 9 and say that was equal to 3. All right, so that was square roots. Now with cube roots, I could say that, you know, 2 times 2 times 2 is 8. Or 2 cubed is 8, right? So since 2 cubed is 8, the cube root of 8 is 2. Okay, and that's how we write it. We do the little square root symbol with a little 3 on there. So the cubed root of 3 is, I mean, the cube root of 8 is 2. Okay? So, you know, there's just a ton of those. Now, what's neat about cube roots, now we talked about with a square root how you can't have, we said you can't have negative 9 times, you can't find the square root of a negative 81, right? Because you're always going to end up with something like that. However, what happens if I say negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2? So kind of like what I just did. I did 2 times 2 times 2 is 8. Negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2 is negative 8, right? Because that's 4, positive 4 times negative 2, right? Gives me negative 8. So I can say negative 2 cubed is negative 8, and therefore the cubed root of negative 8 is in fact negative 2. So what's cool about cube roots is that you can find cube roots of negative numbers. So it's kind of cool. You can find cube roots of negative numbers. So the same thing will happen, like if I want to find that we used before. So if I have the cube root of, say, x, well, we do, before we did the square root of x to the sixth, right? And I said really the best thing to do, in fact, we didn't write the 2, we just wrote that. We said the best thing to do is just take that 6 and divide it by 2 to get 3. Well, if I want to take, say, the cube root of something like that, really I just want to take that 15 and divide it by 3. 15 divided by 3. And that's really the fastest way to do it. Because literally that's, you know, x to the fifth times x to the fifth times x to the fifth. You add those together and you get something off the page, x to the 15. Okay? So these are really not meant to be a whole lot worse. It's just kind of more of the same. We're just kind of stretching you a little bit to see what you can do. So let me give you a bunch of these to work. Okay, so here's a bunch of problems to try to practice with. So work through these. Pause the video. Work through them. See if they make sense. See if you get the right answer. And then come back here and we'll work them together. And we'll pretend that you've done that. I don't know if anyone ever actually does that. But I think they do. I think people say that they do. It's good for you, dang it, because it'll make you a better person. All right, so some of these, it's just going to be hard if you don't have them memorized. So if I have the cube root of 64, I know it's not 2 because it's going to be 2 times 2 times 2 is 8. 3 times 3 times 3 is 27. 4 times 4 times 4 is going to be 16 times 4. There's 64. Okay, you might want to just have a couple of these memorized in your head. Like that. So I might memorize those four, 8, 27, 64, and 125. Those are probably the only ones that you're going to see a whole lot of. So the cube root of 64 is going to be 4. The cube root of negative 64 is going to simply be negative 4. Cube root of negative 27, negative 3. The cube root of 27 is just 3. Now the cube root of x cubed, remember I'm just going to take this number divided by that number. So 3 divided by 3 is 1, so x to the first, or just x. The cube root of 1, it's kind of a tricky question, is just 1, right? Because we could add this, 1 times 1 times 1 is 1. These you're just going to pull out. So 2 fifths. Here it'll be negative 8 cube root and 125 cube root. So negative 2 fifths. Again, I'm just going to divide. 6 divided by 3 is x squared. This one I'm going to break up into pieces again. Cube root of negative 27 times the cube root of x to the 9. So it's negative 3. 9 divided by 3 is x cubed. Okay. So really can't do too much weird with it. It's just, well, they can, but that's cube roots. Now, aside from cube roots, so you got square roots, you got cube roots, and then we have what we call it, like, nth roots, which are just generic anything. So, you know, like we had the 2 times 2 times 2 is 8. You know, 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 would be, I can do this, 16. Would be 32, you know, so that would be 2 to the 4th. That would be 2 to the 5th. So these are like the nth root. Say this, the 4th root of 16 would be considered 2. The 5th root of 16, I mean, yeah, the 5th root of 16, sorry, the 5th root of 32 would be 2. You know, something like, you know, 3 to the 4th is 81. And I could say the 4th root of 81 is 3, something like that. So it's just, honestly, it's just a case of getting used to these numbers and seeing them a whole lot. Let's see. I don't really think we go too crazy on these. No, I'm just moving them around. So that would be 81 times 3. I think this is about as high as we go. And you just need to kind of have some of these memorized. They're really not that bad if you just work them out. I mean, you can work them out by hand in a matter of seconds, like at the beginning of a test. Make yourself a little table with some of these on there so that you'll remember what they are. We can add another one over here. So if I have 6 twos, 8 times 8 is 64. All right. So it's just the same. Now, a couple of things you need to remember. We can't take the 2nd, 4th, 6th, 8th, 10th, etc. root of a negative number. Right? And that's, again, because if I multiply two negative numbers together, I'm going to get a positive number. So if I multiply four negative numbers together or six negative numbers together, so like here's four negative numbers, what's going to happen? Those two negatives are going to cancel out and those two negatives are going to cancel out. So I can't find any even numbered root I can't find for a negative number, but I can take the 3rd, 5th, 7th root of a negative number. And again, that's because if I think about it, if I've got 5 of these, you know, these will become positive, but this guy's still going to be negative. So negative positive 16 times negative 2 is still going to be negative 32. So I can take a 5th root of that, but I can't take a negative, but I can't take a 4th root of a negative number. Okay. So let me just give you a few of those because I don't want to belabor the point too much. Okay, so try some of these. See if you can get them. Pause the video, work them out, come back and see what we got. Okay. Pretending you've done that. So if you've kind of looked at your chart that we made up here a little bit, you'll see that's going to be 3. 3 times 3 times 3 times 3 is 81. Now, 243, that would be another 3. Yeah. But this time it's going to be negative. And I can do that because it's a fifth group. This is just to help you remember. It's a square root of 25 is 5. It's got the negative sign out front, so we're good to go. This one can't do it. Not real. Okay. And then this one, I'm going to break it up. So I've got 4, and 3 divided by 3 is 1, or 4x. Got it? Not so bad, right?